Hello everybody, my name is Textmarker and today we are going to play a little bit of Volcanoids. I have already played for 2 hours just to get a basic grasp of the game and not be completely unprepared. Volcanoids is a survival game set in a steampunk universe, which brings a lot of its own unique mechanics and quirks. We're going to start a new game and obviously we play single player and we are going to go into hard mode this time. The last time I played on normal difficulty and I think I want to check out.
Adranos used to be a wondrous place, a rich and prosperous island, home to a busy trading port. But that was not meant to last. It began when strange formations like giant soil tracks started to appear across the island. No one was able to explain how they were made. Soon after the formations appeared, earthquakes followed. Weak at first, they grew more frequent and more violent. A few days later, 3 volcanoes erupted in the island lagoon, hurling stones, sinking ships, crushing buildings. Captains feared for the safety of their vessels. All trade stopped. People left Adranos aboard fleeing ships. The brave few who had remained soon regretted their decision. An enormous volcano that lay dormant for centuries erupted, flooding the island with a pyroclastic wave, covering it with lava and hurling stones miles away. Those who had made it to the ships were evacuated, myself among them. What we left behind was an apocalyptic landscape of fire and dust. Periodic eruptions turned our beautiful home into a hellish nightmare, disrupting both naval and aerial traffic for years. Despite their best efforts, not even the best Imperial geologists were able to explain the volcano's sudden appearance. Several years later, exiles from Adranos secured funding for an expedition to return to the island and discover what happened. It was my honor to serve as the captain of the Archimedes submarine. As we surfaced a safe distance from Adranos' shore, we knew that this expedition to reclaim our homeland had only just begun.
As I was saying, we're going to play on hard mode. I think I should be at least a bit experienced enough to conquer that challenge. I do not know if the enemies will get significantly stronger or if they basically stay the same or how everything of that is going to be. All right, we are starting out on the submarine and we are not playing the tutorial. Usually there would be the captain standing here and giving you the first tutorial step, which is to craft a drill ship core to claim a drill ship that is going to be vacant soon. We're going to hear a they picked up a distress call or something like that from that drill ship, and the player has to claim that drill ship and use it to survive on this island that is regularly plagued by volcanic eruptions. And we are going to see what all that is about soon enough. In the top middle, you can see a timer running down when the next volcanic eruption is going to take place. I'm going to loot everything, every inventory that's down in the ship. Oh, the captain is sleeping here. I didn't know that. The last time I played on normal difficulty and just went with a tutorial, and then played for an additional, I don't know, 1.5 hours or something like that, and gathered some more experience, and at least I know the basics of the game now. But we will see a lot more difficulties. And we already see the enemies, those robots. There's another one, those autonomous robots. On normal difficulty, there were no robots running around the shore, which is quite interesting. I'm trying to get a headshot in, but... Oh, and the other one seems to be alerted as well. No, no, he's not. If you hit the... This is one of the military shotgun near combat dudes. If you hit him in the head, they get stunned for a few seconds, 2 seconds or something like that, which is quite a lot in a fast-paced combat. And there's the another one. They... Also, that was a bad shot. They also drop resources. My aim is terrible. Where the hell am I aiming? That was a headshot, but he's not stunned, so maybe this is not going to happen on this difficulty. On the bottom left, you can see my health bar. I have taken, I think, 2 shots or something like that, but I'm not that severely injured. This is the drill that we will claim quite soon, but it is defended apparently. Okay.
Okay.
The first task was to find some technology from those robots, because they are more advanced in terms of technology than the protagonist in our nation or tribe or whatever. And that those are those big two pieces of whatever. There are more robots patrolling around these buildings, so I have to look out and be careful not to draw too much attention. In the bottom right, you can see how much ammo I have left and if the gun is loaded. That's a... And there are different types of robots. You can see this one has a pistol as well. He's only shooting one round per shot, and the other shotgun guys obviously shoot several rounds per shot. And as you might have seen, there's a builder head. So this one was a builder, and they all drop different resources, and you can process these resources like the builder head into other information about the technology from those robots. Now we are going to go back to the submarine to craft the drillship core, but apparently one of the robots has already respawned. I do not know about their respawn behavior or how often they respawn or anything like that, which is quite interesting. But I do not intend on fighting that much because I do not have that much ammo right now. I need more resources to craft more ammo, obviously. Some of the robots will also drop some ammunition for shotgun ammo or whatever. I will now just craft everything I can. I do not have that much coal, which is the biggest problem as of right now. I only need the intel, and there it already is. Going to take this, and we're going to craft a drillship core. Nice.
Nice.
This is the work table, by the way. You have different tabs where you can craft different things. This will get filled with much more blueprints later on. I'm going to jump a bit through the early stuff because I have to make sure I already have claimed the drill before the volcano erupts. Otherwise, we will die, which is something we do not want to do. And there is this guy. He's stunned. Okay, so it definitely works on this difficulty. I do not know why the other one wasn't stunned, because I most definitely hit him in the head. But I don't know, maybe it wasn't registered, or I think he was reloading. Maybe that messes... Oh, gee. Whoa! What? Why are there so many? That's not good. Okay. Oh, that was maybe not the best idea. Maybe I should have crafted a grenade. I don't even know if I have enough ammunition for all of them. Ooh, this is going to be... Yeah, this might have been not the best decision. Maybe I should have checked if there's another drill ship that is not occupied right now. Where the hell is that one guy going? Is he going to get repaired? And my last shot. That's it. I'm done. Can I go into... Oh, I can go into close combat? Yeah, I can hack them to pieces. But they're going to kill me first. I have to stand still to regenerate health. No, I can... Yeah, I'm dead. Shit. Yeah. I'm going to reclaim my stuff and maybe kill everyone in close combat. I have no... idea what I should do right now. I don't even know if I can reclaim all my stuff. There they are. No, you do not go back. I will murder you. Either, I don't know, maybe the pickaxe is Maybe the pickaxe just one-hits everything in close combat because all of them were done quite fast, but maybe I had already hurt them enough. You? Yeah, okay.
Okay.
I should heal myself. And now, yeah, I do not have any armor left. That means I have to get into close combat with everyone. That is a pain. That is a pain. I should maybe check. Is there a journal or something like that? Because I don't think this is right. I do not have any quests. Yes. Okay, then we're just going to stick with this one and make our way. Ah, two hit. Ah, they seem to be just two hit. Now I have more revolver ammo. And there's another golden one. He seems to be stronger than everyone else. Now, do I have to? Oh, there's another one. Do you have to? At least 60. I must destroy the. Open the door. Hello. Or not. What the hell? Now I. Oh, this is. This is going to be a problem because I have to destroy this. Or can I just destroy this? Or is this one going to go into the ground now? And I can stay inside here? Maybe. We will see soon. Ah, this one's broken. Now I have to kill this one. I have to destroy more modules. The modules are the big things with color on them on the outside. I do not know if you have seen them. There's another one. But he shot the corpse of his friend. I still have to destroy one. No, I want to keep the storage. Right, can I now? What? Do I have to destroy all of them or what? I have 20 seconds left. This is going to be quite a close call. Hello, hello, hello. Why don't you break? Yeah, alright. I'm going to die. I don't see anything left. Or do I have to... Do I have to break everything in here? Maybe I could have just... stayed inside the submarine. Oh no. Ah, now I've died. I think now the drill ship is destroyed, or at least severely damaged. Maybe now I can reclaim my stuff and claim the drill ship. Yeah, I should have stayed in the submarine for the first eruption, maybe, and claim the drill ship after that. That might have been a better idea. Oh, I didn't know this. Wooden chest, a work table, self-appointed copper balls. Interesting, another work table, refinery work table. Interesting, interesting. Oh no, come on. Seriously, where's my backpack? Where's my backpack? I just want my stuff and I will just leave. Did my stuff get deleted? No, sorry, you will just stand down, please. You will stand down as well. Thanks a lot. Ooh, there's another one, there's another one. Ooh, there are two. This is going to be... No, stop it! Now you're done. Thanks a lot. Yeah, this is a mess. This is a complete and utter mess. I cannot see my backpack, but he is going to... Oh, there are even more. They are going to open the door. Maybe I can find my stuff in here. Or maybe I can not, but I can loot. I can loot everything. Oh yeah, give me everything that you got. Where is my backpack? What? Modules on the top? Oh, I did not know that. That you could place modules on the top. Oh, okay. That's good to know. Interesting, because, yeah, I did not realize that the last time I was playing. I was already on the point where I put down my own modules. And I want to keep the storage. And I thought you could only place 3 modules per side downstairs. Oh, is this... the thing where they respawn? I will destroy this one. Maybe Spawn module. Ooh, on the bottom right, it states what it is I am looking at. That's interesting. I was always wondering how the whole respawn mechanic works, but now I know how that works. I would like to... Yeah, I will destroy this one. I need the workstation and a storage module would be nice as well, but I have to destroy 60% of all modules. There's another storage. I will destroy that one and keep the other one on the side. Because I want to put down the gun turrets on the top. You can put down automated gun turrets that will shoot every enemy inside, which is really handy. Which is this? This is a spawn tube. Oh, and that, or it states 50% complete. All right, I will just destroy this one. Nice, nice, nice. You need at least drillship core 1. I need a drillship core. Do you have a work table? You do not. Didn't I pick up a work table? Yes, I did, but I can't place it. Can I see my backpack on the map? No, I cannot. This is a whole mess, guys. Maybe I should have just restarted after I died. But I thought the druidship would have been damaged that I could claim it, but apparently all my inventory was destroyed as well, which is really, really annoying. That means I will have to pick up the technology as well, but I have more time now, so that's not going to be that much of a problem. Now, ooh, I can reclaim the technology from those modules. That's interesting. That's really, really interesting. Cannot really don't have access to this drill ship. No, I do not. I know that. Can I put down the work table? No, I cannot. That is a bit annoying. That means I have to get back to the submarine. But I have to admit, if the supply of medicine is high enough, then close combat with a pickaxe is definitely the most viable and the best option to fight those robots. Oh, I could have closed the door. Oh, come on. And there's this one as well. Oh, okay. Yeah, that was all my not so smart idea. Now we have the drillship core and I crafted some more materials for now. I do not know how the hard difficulty is supposed to be played. I think that I was mostly on the right track, but the safest idea would have been to just stay during the eruption inside the submarine and attack afterwards and not waste so much ammunition on everything that I have wasted ammunition on. Alright, can I... Now, drillship has been successfully claimed. Thank God. Alright, no, I do not want to place this. I want to Where are chests? I want... No, how can I... I don't own any... breach replacements? Apparently I don't. Where are they? Did I drop them? I think I dropped them. Controller shutdown. There are a lot of additional things standing around, but I already have a refinery station, already have a production station. Here's a work table. This seems to be display medium. This seems to be storage. There's more storage, obviously. This is for the power plants. This lever stand up down, maybe for the drill to get down into the ground. There are the refinery things, there are more chests, there's a pilot seat, the quest bar. What is this panel manufacturer small? Okay, I won't mess with that. Refinery, I already have one. That means this one is too much. I will take the scrap
That you could do.
I will take the scrap one for now. Window module chest. No. Now we're going to put this stuff inside here. Because we want to use all of that in the internal crafting system of the drill soon. All right. Module. Oh, module repair kit. I thought those would be the module replacement ones. Oh no, I can't produce yet. I need the according module. I need the production module, obviously. I need Intel Production T1. Do I own that? Intel Production, yes, I do. Now I need all of the stuff back that I have just put inside there. I need 3 copper plates and 1 pump. Oh no, a pump is dropped by enemies. That is going to be another problem. Alright, after that I want the rich replacements. I need copper bowls and copper plates. Means I will just craft 3 more plates. But I will probably need more. There is one. One, there's one. This looks way better. And I need 3 additional ones. I think, no, everything seems to be working out nice and shiny. Now is everything is back to normal. This is great. We have 1 storage module and that is it for now. We have 2 doors, which is okay, but I mean, we have 2 door frames and 1 door. I should probably craft another door. Copper door, 1 copper plate, please. And then the door. Oh, I have to stay in that menu to continue crafting. Yes, put it down, please. Thank you quite a lot. I will pick up most of those chests because I'm not going to need that much storage. I will much rather use the storage system of the drill because from that I can access... Oh, do I have a pump? I already own a pump! Oh, good lord, I'm so... Sometimes I'm a bit stupid. 3 copper plates and 1 bolt. Now I can craft the production module tier 1 and that will offer me way much more new stuff to produce. That is great to know. I want to put down the storage. I will put it down. Yeah, I think. Yep. No, not the... I can't deconstruct. Okay. Why can't I put it down there? I don't know. Then I will just put it down there. Nice. Now this is working. And now we can craft stuff in here. Now we can use the internal storage system of the drill. Nice. I need research. Work table, chest, refinery. I need a research work table. 1 copper bolt and 1 copper plate. No. This was right. I nearly crafted way too much. And now I can just move away from this one because it's going to be crafted by itself. Where do we put you for now? How about there? This looks terrible. Rotate with Q. Yes, that's what I want to see. All right, how much coal? 35. I think I heard... Yes, there are robots. Where the hell are... No, I don't want to destroy this. Where the hell are you? There he is. Stop it. I need to craft some medicine. And I have to repair my ship. He destroyed a little bit. Yeah, he did a little bit of damage. This... Now it is gone. Apparently the display is going to stay this way, which is quite annoying. But I will... Produce some consumable? No. Hier, Medkit, 2 copper tubes. No, I need medicine first. The robot is down here. Where the hell do you come from? Stop it with the destruction. Oh, he did quite a lot of damage. Oh, this light is different. That light is an additional piece of decoration, I suppose. I will keep the doors shut for now. Where were we? No. Then we do not have enough materials for another med kit. I will take these. Thanks a lot. Now, I have to check which upgrades this drill already has. It has the upgrade starter production, upgrade starter research, and upgrade starter refinery. The refinery, the research, and the production. That means we need simple explosives and starter structures. We will stick with the simple explosives to craft some grenades quite soon. I haven't used them the last time I played. Is it already dropped in? Yes, it is already dropped there. I mean, just to tick every box, we will craft this one as well. Now that this is finished, now we have finished all the schematics available to us right now. And we have also gained a few new blueprints. We can build a second drill ship segment. We can build a hardened drill, although this is going to be a tough one because we need alloys for that and hardened drill parts. And we have to go down. We have to go underground now because the volcano is going to erupt quite soon. I will fix this one for now. And the siren is going off. That means packing all things together and going down into the tunnels to be safe from the volcanic eruption. And we have our own base now. Yeah, there's not much going to happen now with this cutscene. The volcano is going to erupt quite soon. I don't have a periscope, I think. There is one. Yeah, there is one here. We will place it down now and I can show you what happens outside. The volcano is going to erupt in 30 seconds. And from here on out, I will just show you the map. We can move down in the tunnels. And we can use the tunnels. We can farm some ores here. And we can move through different levels. As you can see, is the surface, the tunnels one. There's caves, which is basically surface inside the tunnels. And there's a second caves layer. And then there are those additional tunnel layers. And the volcano is going to erupt now. It's always spilling no debris, apparently. It's only this ash cloud that is engulfing everything. But it is not hazardous. That means right now I could go back to the surface and continue exploring and gathering up there. Now we can move down here and we can move to different spots like the harbor area where we left off right now. You can see those tracks. Apparently you cannot see the tracks. I thought you could see them. Well, apparently not. And you can only surface at those You can only surface at those specific locations. Now this sign means that there is another drill. There should be. Yeah, landing site occupied by a drill ship. Oh, that is. Yeah, this is an enemy drill ship. I can attack this one like I attack the one I am sitting in right now and claim the modules and keep the destroyed things of those modules to harvest them and produce technology from them. You can see the robots patrolling around the drill ship and the drill ship doing its thing. And we are underground now and we can discover more places to surface. This is the one we have already discovered. And this is the only part of the tunnels that we have discovered as of right now. All right, we are going to leave it at that for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you had a great time. If you did, leave a like and a comment for the algorithm. And as always, stay safe out there.